Hello everyone, welcome back to AeroHub and welcome to the series of lectures in aerospace structures. In the previous lecture we discussed how to estimate the bending stress for a fuselage frame, and in this lecture we will discuss how to estimate the shear flow distribution of a fuselage frame, especially in the fuselage skin panels. Okay, we will be continuing the same question which we have done for the bending stress in the previous lecture. We are using the same diagram. As you can see, we have a fuselage frame in circular shape and I am applying a load of 100 kN at a distance 150 mm from the vertical axis of symmetry, and we have 16 boom areas from 1 to 16, and each boom area is 216.6 mm², and they have given the value of moment of inertia as Ix is equal to 2.52 × 10⁸ mm²/4. Okay, so we have calculated the value of boom areas and moment of inertia in the previous question. We are doing the same question, just we are applying the load of 100 kN at a distance of 150 mm from the vertical axis of symmetry, and they are asking to find out the value of shear flow throughout the section. And as you are aware that the boom areas will be carrying the bending stress and the skin will be carrying the shear stress or shear flow. So therefore we have to find out the value of shear flow for the skin panels from 1.2 to the 4.116. Okay. And also you have to understand, and we are aware that this section is a closed section. So to find out the value of shear flow for closed section, we have the general formula. Qs is equal to Qb plus Qs naught. Okay, and Qb is the basic shear flow and Qs naught is nothing but the shear flow where we made a cut. So in this case I will make a cut on the portion 1.2. Okay, and when you make a cut on the portion 1.2, automatically the shear flow for this skin panel 1.2 will be zero. Okay, and you are also aware that when between the two booms, the shear flow distribution will be always a constant. Okay, when you have a boom area, the shear flow distribution between the boom areas will be constant. And when you cross one boom, there will be certain amount of change in the shear flow. Okay, so the Qb12, that is the shear flow, basic shear flow for Qb12 will be zero because we have made a cut. Okay, now we are aware about the formula of Qb. Qb is nothing but the basic shear flow. When you make a cut on the skin panel 1.2, basically this section become an open section. This section is actually a closed section. When you made a cut on portion 1.2, the section became an open section, and for open section the value of shear flow is Qb is equal to minus Sy divided by Ixx into summation r is equal to 1 to n Br Yr. Okay, Br is the boom area that is given as 216.6 mm² for each and every boom, and Yr is the distance from the neutral axis. For example, for boom 1, the distance is given as 381 mm. All dimensions are in millimeters here. Similarly, for boom 9, the distance y will be minus 381 because boom 9 is below the neutral axis. Okay, and we have this formula, so I can apply the value of Sy. Sy is nothing but the shear force along y direction, that is 100 kN, and Ix is 2.52 × 10⁸ mm²/4. So I can apply the value of Sy and Ix, so I can generate an equation which is a constant throughout our analysis. That will be minus of 100 × 10³ divided by 2.52 × 10⁸ summation r is equal to 1 to n Br Yr. So I'll be getting an answer of minus 3.97 × 10⁻⁴. This is the value of 100 × 10�³ divided by 2.58, and we have this term, that term will be summation R is equal to 1 to n B R Y R. Okay, so we got the equation for basic shear flow. Now we have to find out the basic shear flow value for entire section. Okay, so I will start from the boom 2 and we will find out the shear flow for the entire section. Okay. Now, as you are aware that we made a cut for the portion 1, 2, the shear flow value will be 0 here. So I'll first find out the value of QB 2, 3. So for portion 1, 2, we are crossing the portion boom area number 1, the shear flow is 0. Okay, we already know. And for portion 2, 3, QB 2, 3, we have to consider the shear flow for the previous skin panel, that is QB 1, 2. The shear flow for QB 1, 2 is 0 plus minus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4, and we are crossing the boom number 2, and boom number 2 is having a boom area of 216.6, and the length from the neutral axis is 352. Okay, from the figure we have this value as 352. Okay, so I'll be getting an answer of minus 30.28. so this is the value for shear flow for boom skin panel 2, 3, and we assume the shear flow from boom 2 to 3, we got a negative value, so this will be in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, we assume the shear flow, the shear flow is from 2 to 3. Okay, but we got a negative value, so the direction of shear flow is in anti-clockwise direction. Similarly, we will find out for QB 3, 4. QB 3, 4 is equal to, we have to consider the shear flow for the previous skin panel, that is QB 2, 3, that is minus 30.28 plus minus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4. The boom area is constant, 216.6, and the distance is between boom area 3 and the neutral axis is 269.5. okay, this will be equal to, the answer will be equal to minus 53.43. so for boom area skin panel 3, 4, we are crossing boom 3, the answer is minus 53.43, and this also will be anti-clockwise direction. Okay, similarly for boom QB 4, 5, we have to consider the shear flow for QB 2, 3, 3, 4, that will be minus 53, that is the previous shear flow, plus minus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4 into 216.6. the distance of boom 4 from the neutral axis is 145.8. I think, yeah, that's correct. So I'll be getting an answer of minus 66 for skin panel 4, 5. We are crossing the boom 4, so I'll be getting minus 66. And for this is in anti-clockwise direction because we are considering the flow from 4 to 5, but the value is negative, therefore the shear flow is reversed, so it will be from 5 to 4. And for boom skin panel 5 to 6, we are crossing the boom 5. Okay, and boom area 5 is exactly at the neutral axis. So the value of Y of boom area 5, that is QB 5, 6, for QB 5, 6, we have to consider the previous skin panel shear flow, that is minus 66 plus minus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4 into 216.6 into the value of Y for boom area number 5 will be 0. So this part becomes 0. So QB 5, 6 will be minus 66. So it will be minus 66. Okay. And now we have to go for QB 6, 7. QB 6, 7 is equal to, we have to consider the shear flow for the previous skin panel, that is minus 66 we have newton per millimeter everywhere. I am skipping that, sorry. Newton per millimeter. Okay, QB67, while considering QB67, we have to consider the previous skin panel shear flow, that is minus 66 plus minus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4 into 216.6, and this is 67. We are crossing the boom number 6, and boom number 6 is at a distance of 145.8. Since the boom number 6 is below the neutral axis, I can write this as minus 145.8. Okay, this is minus because boom number 6 is below the neutral axis. That's why minus 145.8. So I'll be getting an answer of minus 53.43. QB67. Yes. Minus 53.43. Similarly, we have to continue for this section. After completing the shear flow for 8, 9 will be 0 because we have 1, 2 are 0. So similarly, 8, 9 will be also 0. After completing the calculation, you will be getting the answer. After completing the portion 8, 9, you have to start from portion 116. Okay, QB 116. Okay, then you have to continue up to boom number 9. Okay. I repeat, after completing the skin panel 8, 9, we have to start from the skin panel 116. Then we have to find out the values of shear flow for each and every skin panel. Okay. For example, I will find out QB116. So that will be, we are passing the boom number 1. And the previous shear flow will be 0, that is 1, 2, that is 0. 0 plus 3.97 into 10 power minus 4 into 216.6 into 381. And I will be getting an answer of minus 32.8. Okay, this is the answer for QB116. So we assume the flow from 1 to 16, but we got in negative value. So this will be in anti-clockwise, not anti-clockwise, in a reverse direction. So for this section, that is from 1 to 9, I got an anti-clockwise flow, and from 1 to 9, or from this position, in this case, I'll be getting a clockwise flow. Okay, and the answer is minus 32.8. Okay, so you have to calculate for entire boom like this. I am not doing the entire calculation, that it will be time consuming. So I'll be writing the value. So I got the entire values of basic shear flow for the entire skin panel. For 116 is minus 32.8, and 1615 it is minus 63.1. And 1540 is minus 86.3, 1413 is minus 98.8, as well as for 1312, 1211 is minus 86.3, 1110 is minus 63.1, 1009 is minus 32.8. And we assume the flow from 1 to 16 in this direction, but we got the value as negative, so that will be from 16 to 1. And you can see in this case, from half of this section towards the right hand side, we got a flow in anti-clockwise direction, and on the left hand side, I got a shear flow in clockwise direction. Okay. Now we have to find out the value of QS0. To find out the value of QS0, we have to take the moment. Okay. We have to take a moment of the shear flow. That is, the internal moment should balance the external moment, and we are applying a shear load of 150 kilonewton, of 100 kilonewton, at a distance of 150 mm. Okay, from the question you are aware, we are applying a load of 100 kilonewton somewhere here. We are applying a load of 100 kilonewton at a distance of 150 mm from the vertical axis of symmetry. Okay. Now this moment should balance the moment created by the shear flow. Okay. This moment should balance the moment created by the